President Marcos gives high praise to Cavite Governor John Vicrimulya as a new Secretary of the Interior Department. He took his oath in Malacañang this morning. Rimulya replaces Benner Abalos, who resigned to run for Senator. Marcos says a younger Rimulya fits the bill of a DILG leader the country needs today. The President believes John Vic is more than qualified to handle the challenges of one of the government's most important jobs. Mr. Marcos also cited Rimulya's achievements, noting his work in turning Cavite into a progressive and economic powerhouse. Rimulya's appointment makes him the second Rimulya on the cabinet, where he joins his brother, Jesus Crispin, who is the Justice Secretary. Meanwhile, Vice Governor Athena Tolentino takes over as Governor of Cavite. Let's now talk to Interior Secretary John Vic Rimulya. Mr. Secretary, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron. Good afternoon, Denise.
Nice to talk to you again, sir. No, we knew you had that intention to run for your last term as governor, but that changed somewhere along the way. What's the story and how you ended up as the new DILG secretary, sir?
The president and I have had conversations for the last few months, but it's always been on the background and it's always been contingent upon Secretary Benher running for the Senate. And to with respect to Senator Abalos, and with the way politics are, we decided to withhold any information or announcement until Secretary Abalos, or this even the decision was made only after Secretary Abalos filed for the Senate.
Mr. Secretary, we do want to know, was it your brother who encouraged and endorsed you for the post, sir?
No, not at all, not at all. My relationship with the family and my brother's relationship is both solid, but this has been a conversation between the president and I for the longest time.
Okay. We've heard the statements of Secretary Boying. He believes that the two of you working together would have a big impact on the justice system. What do you think would be the advantage to you and the interior and local government of having a brother by your side there at the cabinet?
Well, the lines are more open and the filters are less apparent with the two of us. We call a spade a spade, and he's always been my older brother, and I've always taken his advice. But he's also listened to me in all these things. So we have a great synergy at work. We've succeeded in everything we've tried to do. And I think we can do great things together as a tandem in this for the Justice Department and for the Interior Department.
Now, we've seen siblings work together in the House of Representatives as well as the Senate, but are you concerned at all about criticisms of nepotism, possible conflicts of interest and objectivity, most especially if there comes a situation where the Justice Department would be investigating something that involves your department?
We serve at the pleasure of the president. I don't think nepotism is an issue because we did not appoint each other. It is the president who appointed us. I think the bigger issue is whether we're competent and qualified for the job that we are doing. I think my brother has proven himself, and I hope to bring my 30 years of experience in local government to the table and prove myself to us worthy of the position.
And speaking of that, you're almost three decades of service from the local government. What would you be bringing in from your past experiences to this broader role?
Well, there is the human side that I have developed and have witnessed, and I have been close witness to in service. But there's also the professional side. In 30 years, I've seen the best and the worst of people, the best and the worst of public servants, the best and the worst of policies. During my incumbency as governor, I have corrected most of them, and I think we ran a very smooth ship. We have encountered no problems, and in fact, have been awarded many awards for governance. Mm-hmm. So I hope to bring the same type of energy and dedication to the department, and I start tomorrow.
In a statement, sir, you've said that, that part of your advocacy was aiming for the strengthening of the local government as well as the police. How will you be doing that in your new position? What will be in your priorities?
My priority is, number one, the responsiveness of the local government to digitization. I think we're left behind in the world. I think we're one of the few places in the world where you can't pay real property taxes online. And I think we will create a system and a portal common to all LGUs so that online payment of municipal and city taxes and city fees are done online in the most efficient way possible. There are other avenues too which we have to explore, like creating a unified 9/11 response system throughout the country, which is now on a piecemeal basis. Also, I want to streamline the work process of the local chief executive. I've been chief executive for 11 and a half years, mm-hmm. and I've talked to all of the local chief executives, and all of us have the same sentiment. Why do we have to devote 10 to 12 hours every week signing papers and we can do so much more with that? I hope to work with COA to come up with a more streamlined process of the workflow of all chief executives in the country.
The new head of the DILG, John Vikrimulya. Mr. Secretary, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you also.